Hey! Careful, or you'll end up like me. Boy, howdy, that's a long way down.
What are you doing here, Tex?
You tell me.
Yeah, what happened?
The day I died?
I know that was a safe stunt. I checked everything myself, every little detail. So what happened?
Who is it?
No, just some guy.
You cheating on me?
Never. See, I'm hanging up on him.
Blood Curse 2, the movie that Tex died on. There was a time when I watched it over and over again, trying to figure out what went wrong. But that was years ago. I had to let it go.
You sure?
Yes, Tex. I'm sure.
Are you really sure?
I have to let you go.
Who the fuck are you talking to?
Hollywood. Some people don't like it because they think everything's fake. But I never had a problem with that. I couldn't. I was a stuntman, and my job was to make fake look real.
Okay, Mark.
Right on.
How does it look?
Let's rock and roll.
Yeah! Get some!
And let's show them how reaction's done.
Be camera safe.
Get back! We're about to...
Unfortunately, there are times when fake becomes real. Too real.
Det här är en tjej som du snackar om. Vi borde visa det här för henne. Om du ger henne ett minne av deras sista kyss så blir hon säkert lite trevligare mot dig.
Skulle inte tro det. Det är inte hans tjej.
Va?
That woman was the girlfriend of a low-level Russian mobster named Dmitri. He was a total psychopath. At that point, I was convinced it wasn't the stunt that had killed Tex.
Tex?
You don't look too happy to see me.
You're alive.
And so are you, my friend. Thanks to me.
You killed Dmitri?
Yeah, I did.
So it's true then, huh? You're a hitman?
We all have to find our place in the universe.
I saw you die with my own eyes.
It doesn't matter.
What about your accent? That's also fake, just like your death. Just like our friendship, huh?
Believe it or not, Ingmar, I did grow to have feelings for you.
Which is saying a lot, considering I'm a full-blown narcissistic sociopath.
You ruined my life.
True. If it wasn't for me, you'd still be a stone man.
Exactly.
With a broken-up body. And a broken-up relationship with the one thing you've learned to love more than anything in the world. Your daughter.
So what's now?
That's up to you, Ingmar.
But I can't just let you walk away.
I'm warning you. Drop this. Don't come looking for me and don't talk to the FBI about our little meeting.
Or what?
If you do, I'm gonna find you and I'm gonna kill you right after I kill your daughter. Great to see you. You take care now.
Yellow.
Did you get my message? Sure you did.
The beating in the garage?
Just wanted to let you know that I'm around. This is what happens when you talk to the FBI.
I didn't say anything.
Shut up and listen. Next time, it's your daughter.
Tex, you don't have to worry about me saying anything to anybody. In fact, I'm moving back home.
To Switzerland?
No, Sweden.
I think it would be best for all of us
if I go back.
Yes.
That makes sense. Good luck.
Thanks.
One more thing.
Yeah, what?
Remember to flush.
Tex?
Who the fuck is Jane McKinney?
Nobody. Small-time private
investigator. Loser. Nothing
to worry about.
You always were a terrible liar.
Because I'm addicted to the truth.
You want the truth? I'll give you the truth. If you don't stop McKinney from taking the case, people will die.
Hello.
I want you to listen to what I'm about to say.
There's been a huge change of plan.
You don't understand.
Shut up and listen.
A job came up. Doing it as we speak. And this one, it's going in the history books.
The heat's gonna be out of control. I'll have to hightail it out of the country.
What? Another killing?
Keep your mouth shut. By this time tomorrow, you and Sarah will be out of harm's way.
Well, I just turned myself in for what you did to keep your name out of it.
Seriously?
Seriously.
Huh. That's too bad. Especially if the guy in the coma dies.
But that's not my problem.
See you later, alligator.
Okay, du kollar här. Var försiktig.
always had a lot of respect for you, Ingmar. Never give up. Never quit. You always wanted to make the stunts better. But this isn't a stunt.
It's for real.
You're the main character.
Goodbye, old friend.
Did you just...
Nope.
Yes, you did.
No.
Say it.
No.
Say it.
No.
Say it. No. Seriously? You came in here like a fucking movie star and you couldn't even...
How you doing, pal?
How am I doing? I'm glad it was one of you guys, and not some cop or FBI agent or fast food worker.
Why would it be a fast food worker?
No fucking clue.
You know, you were right. What you said about saving my life.
I was. Damn. I guess it wasn't pure evil after all.
Nope. But pretty damn close.
I can live with that.
Yeah. Why are you slow clapping?
You think that was slow? I show you this.
And how I finally was able to put the ghost of Tex to rest.
No touch.
No.
Or did I?
Why are you here, Zorro?
Zorro? Please. Don't listen to that other guy. He's a clown. Help me. Find me. Forgive me.
Ingmar!
Forgive me.
Ingmar!
Don't be afraid.
Ingmar!
Heck!
I'm sorry.
Tex?
I need to tell you. Talk to me.
What do you want to tell me?
Ingmar, listen.
I'm listening.
I'm sorry.
Ingmar, try to visualize Tex into reality, okay? See him. See him right in front of you.
Tex.
Ingmar. What am I doing here?
I think I summoned you.
Oh.
You said you wanted to tell me something yesterday.
Right. There's so much. You still don't understand.
I'm so sorry Axel killed you. He feels really bad about it.
Nah. Tell the little fella I understand. But you, Ingmar, you need to know that something...
He's gone.
Kind of chilly in here.
Yeah. When are you gonna tell us the name of this Mr. Klein?
I shot you. I saw you die.
Did you?
He's dead! He's dead! He saw you die in my arms.
I saw you die.
What the fuck is going on, Dave?
Ingmar.
What?
Ingmar. It's good to see you, pal.
Would you excuse us?
Of course.
Okay. So you see him too, right?
Of course I do. It's not a ghost.
Keep it together, man.
You keep it together. Got any idea what I've been going through?
What you've been going through?
Yeah.
I'm the one who killed him. Still plays along in a loop in my head with Dancing Queen and the theme from Friends. Do you have any idea what it's like to kill a man?
Of course I do. I killed him first.
I actually killed him.
I know it's a lot to take in.
How did you survive?
The funk saved my life.
What?
After you left me for dead, I hobbled like a broken commando out of that big building. And then I fell. I fell 5 stories and landed in the back seat of a lowrider. I was nearly dead. This time for real. Were not for one thing. The funk pumping through those speakers that went into my lifeless body. And it restarted my heart. The funk was like a defibrillator. I know there's no way I'd have survived if they were listening to Celtic music or country. The funk saved my life. Then the coppers had me. And you know what? It's the best thing that's ever happened to me. I'm never getting out of here. But still, I'm a happy man. And the reason for that is a man named Oscar Bustamante.
Who is Oscar Bustamante?
Oscar Bustamante is a former city councilman. Corrupt son of a bitch. He's doing life for murder here.
Yes, Ingmar. But he's also my savior. He taught me how to play the sax and how to be human again. He's also innocent. At least of the murder.
Bullshit!
He was framed, Ingmar! And I need your help to prove it. You're the best. And I trust you, and you're my friend. Help me. Help me help Oscar. I can pay you. I can pay you a lot of money.
I'll never be able to thank you enough.
No, Oscar. Thank you.
Remember to practice your sax, Tex. Think, Sonny Rollins.
Will do.
I don't know how I'm ever gonna thank you for giving me my life back. Tex told me I could trust you, and I'm glad that I did.
It's been a pleasure, Mr. Bustamante.
Yeah, except for the getting tied up and the gas part.
I just have one thing to say. I love the Dicks.
Thank you, Ingmar. I did it for the money.
Really?
Yeah.
Not because we're friends?
For the money.
It was a big case.
It was a big case.
So I helped you?
You helped me, yeah. Bye, Tex.
Ingmar! I need you to help me when my time comes. I'm innocent, too.
I'm just kidding, man. I'm guilty as shit.
I owe you, pal. You're the best.
Great job.
Great job. Visit any time. I'll be here. Fellas, take me home.
Sure, I know the Joe. Up and comer.
Is it really the Joe, not just Joe?
It's the Joe. Look, here's the lowdown. The Joe isn't going to stop until the Mark is dead.
But my client's willing to pay the Joe double to call it off. He wants to live now.
It doesn't work that way, I'm sorry. The Joe has a contract. They'll deliver on it.
Okay, so what can I do?
I hate going against my own kind. But we're friends, right?
Right.
Right. Smoked them out. Set a trap. Use the mark as bait. Then whammo.
Whammo.
Whammo. You got the Joe.
Right.
If you told me 20 years ago that I'd become a prison funk guru, I swear, I would have thrown you out of my trailer. I was heavily into rap metal back then. But life takes you unexpected places.
Why am I here, Tex?
Being in here makes you think about what's important in life. Friends are important, and I consider you my friend, Ingmar.
Okay.
Have you met Warden Johnson? She's kind of a funk fiend, so we get along great.
And?
And apparently she hired this PI broad, Jane something.
Jane McKinney?
Right, but it's not working out. So I was thinking it could be an opportunity for you guys to, you know, swoop in. Do you want me to set up a meeting?
Do you know what happens to my feelings? They get hurt?
Yeah!
They get fucking hurt.
Hey, cut it out, Jeremy! I said cut it out!
That's right. Keep walking, Jeremy.
Don't look at me.
Hey, Tex.
I said don't look at me.
Oh, sorry.
You're not going to get anywhere in here if people don't respect you.
I know. I can't make them respect me.
Hey. Hey, Fred. Great jam earlier. Very funky.
Yeah. Really took my mind off my urges and shit.
That's awesome, man. Just remember what we talked about. Keep up the funk.
Keep up the funk, Tex.
You need to pick a fight with the most badass guy in prison. And you need to win.
I can't win against these guys.
Yes, you can.
Oh, you mean?
Yes.
Wait, what do you mean?
Who do you think is the most badass guy in here?
Who?
Me. Keep up the funk.
Hello, Tex.
Hello.
Do you know who I am?
You must be Jane McKinney.
Do you know why I'm here?
To ruin my dinner.
I know you're working with Axel, and I want you to come and work with me instead.
That's not gonna happen.
I'll pay you more.
I'm not a whore.
Then this means war. The rhyming was unintentional.
On my part as well. Hey, what are you doing?
I want to watch my show.
Change it back.
Or what?
You don't want to know what.
Oh, but I do want to know what.
No, you don't.
Oh, but I do.
But you don't.
But I do. Yeah! Who's next? You! You! You!
She said that. One move and your dick will find out. That's great. I'm gonna use that next time I'm in a standoff. Speaking of that, how's Jeremy?
Oh, it didn't hit then the vital organs.
It'll be fine.
Oh, that's good, I guess. I'm proud of you guys. You did it. You really are great detectives.
Thanks, I say it.
So, how does Jane feel about all this? Exactly. Watch your back.
Exactly.
You get right the fuck out of here. Alfred the murderer is getting married?
Well, his name is Axel.
I thought it was Floyd.
Well, it's not Alfred the murderer.
Well, it was when he was in here. And that's kind of how I like to remember him. Who's the bride?
Oh, her name is Eve.
Axel and Eve.
Interesting goal.
Sounds almost biblical.
Almost, yeah.
I've got to be there.
What? At the wedding?
I got to play the wedding march.
How?
You can help me, Ingmar. 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 You can help me, Ingmar.
You know who I am?
Don't you work with Ingmar?
Ingmar works with me. Quick story. When I was little, my grandpa told me about this kid he grew up with, whose best friend was a tree.
His best friend was a tree?
Don't interrupt! As this kid grew up, he would take things from the tree and never give anything back. The tree just gave and gave and gave, and the kid just took and took and took until finally the kid cut down the tree and made a house out of it.
That's from a children's book called The Giving Tree.
You calling my grandpa a liar?
Not at all.
Ingmar got a lot of shit on his mind right now. Axel might get deported.
I thought he was getting married.
Because he might get deported. Keep up! Axel, illegal alien, huh? He is getting married tomorrow, so he not get tossed out on his ear. Because that could be the end of the Dicks.
Oh, shit.
That's right. And still, Ingmar's doing for you. Laying his reputation on the line. That Ingmar, straight up giving tree.
Ingmar and I are friends.
You better be, because I not want any shenanigans. If you want to bring the funk, then bring it. But if this some angle you're playing, then this one fucked up North Korean defect you're gonna wish you never saw. You got that? Texas Johnson?
Got it.
This conversation never happened. Sun out.
There's a murderer playing the saxophone, and whose idea were these wedding favors? I mean, seriously, saltwater taffies?
Alfred. Alfred the murderer. Congratulations, man.
Thanks, Tex.
She's a lovely girl. And maybe someone has told you this, but after 6 marriages, I know it better than anyone. Listen. Oh, no. Listen to your wife. When she says something, man, listen. Even when she's not saying something. Dig me?
Yeah.
Hey, Ingmar.
Hi.
Nice night with Warren Johnson.
Who told you?
Warren Johnson. Appletinis, eh?
Yeah, 4 of them.
Are those saltwater taffies? Come on, fellas. See you later.
Who is exciting.
I don't know how to say it. We just are.
He's losing his mind.
No, it's about love.
I know this is crazy, but are you gonna marry me?
Shit, the fuck.
Yes, I will. I will. I do.
You're definitely my partner from now on. And hurry up before I change my mind.
This is even more romantic.
I love it. It's weird, but...
Let's do this now.
Yeah.
What? No.
Maestro, please? Music!
Nobody move!
Where the fuck is he, motherfucker?
Hello, Ingmar. I'm sorry I broke up your wedding. I kind of had to leave in a hurry.
You're not going back, are you?
To jail? Or to killing people?
You tell me.
No, not going back. I told you, I'm a changed man.
Are you? Because this feels a lot like the last time you played me, my old friend.
Only last time. I didn't come back to thank you.
Oh, to thank me?
Yes. I owe a lot to the funk and to the California penal system. But mostly, I owe you, pal. Just for being a friend. See you around, Ingmar. I'm happy for you and all your success with the Dicks. Everything's going to work out for Axel. I know it. I know it.
Is it a green card?